Hey guys, Ryan here at Signature Edits, and today I'm going to show you how to fix a blown out sky and add sky effects inside of Lightroom. Alright, so sky editing can be one of the trickiest parts of editing a photo. There are so many options how you can fix a blown out sky in Lightroom. Sky replacement is something a lot of photographers do when there's just no detail left in the photo, but as of yet, you can't actually replace the sky in Lightroom without taking your image over to Photoshop. So how do you fix a bright sky or fix and edit the skyline to enhance the colors quickly and easily? That's a question that we're going to look at today. Using the automask feature, we can easily recover highlights and do all sorts of sky effects to enhance our photos. Here's how you do it. First things first, we're going to make a new adjustment brush. We're going to set the size all the way to max, our feather down minimally, and our flow to 100. And then we're going to check this little auto mask box. What that's going to do is allow Lightroom to automatically create your masks for you and save a ton of time, especially if you've got some complicated textures and details that you need to mask out, like these trees here, for instance. Then we're going to zoom out in our photo so that our mask brush, adjustment brush, can cover the entire photo. The reason for this is we're now going to make a sample of a particular part of this sky, and Lightroom, using that one sample, we'll click it once on the photo, is going to automatically grab all of the color information and brightness information that looks like it's related to that one little sample. Now I can actually grab this and move it around to different parts of the image, and Lightroom will again automatically find the different areas of the image that again match up with this point. So if I click again in a different area, now it's going to sample from both the colors like this and the colors down in here. So I'm just going to do that a couple of times and click on my sky here like that. And as you can see, it's automatically filling in and selecting the areas that I'm clicking. Now I clicked too far and it accidentally masked further than I needed it to. So I'm just going to hit Command Z a couple of times to undo that. And then the last thing I'm going to do is go to my secondary brush. I'm going to set the flow up to 100. And this is a smaller brush. I'm going to then take it and just go over the parts of the sky that are easy for me to paint on quickly. So basically what you're doing is you're using Lightroom's auto mask feature to get these fine details here so that you don't have to do it personally. And then afterwards, go over and just make sure that it hasn't missed any tiny little spots. Perfect. So now that I've done that, I'm going to hold Alt and erase and really quickly just erase down in here, because it looks like Lightroom has automatically selected some of this road that doesn't need to be selected. Now I'm going to press O, and that's going to get rid of this red overlay. Okay, now what I can do is just lower my exposure here, and we'll darken the sky just like that. Now if you want to add a little bit more blue to the sky, all you have to do is take your temperature control and just shift it towards blue. And that's a little far, we're going to leave it somewhere around here. And now I'm going to brighten the whole image up. Make this maybe even a little bit darker, up my clarity. I don't need to have any sharpness on there. A little bit of dehaze perhaps, and get rid of the saturation. And just like that, I have gone from here to here. All right, let's keep going. This photo here, I love the vibes, but it's a little washed out looking for me. So I'm going to do the same thing. Again, grabbing my adjustment brush, I'm going to switch to adjustment brush A, make sure that my flow is at 100, size is at 100, and my auto mask is on. Then I'm going to sample a portion of the image here by clicking it. Press O to see where Lightroom is masking, and sure enough, in one click, it has pretty much covered everything. I'm just going to hit this little bit of sky, and it looks like Lightroom's not loving me for that, so we're going to just stick there. Press O again, and same trick. Let's just reset all these settings. I can add a little bit of blue by just taking the color balance down this way, maybe upping my saturation, taking down my exposure a little bit. And just like that, I've gone from here to here. Okay, let's keep going. So another area of sky replacement that can be tricky is getting details back in clouds. So before you actually do this adjustment brush technique, the first thing you need to check is whether or not your image has any detail left anyways. Because if this in camera, if this photo had actually blown out these whites in the clouds, there would be no detail left to rescue in the first place. So an easy trick is you just take your exposure down and see if you were just exposing for the clouds. Okay, we've got a little bit of texture in there, but not a ton. So obviously I'm not worrying about how the rest of the image looks right now, just the clouds. So I could definitely bring some out, but we're going to be watching. There's definitely some purple and some weird noise coming up in here. So we're going to do this now. I'm going to reset and undo those changes. And I'm going to do the same thing as our last couple of images. Go to Adjustment Brush A and just click that sky. Press O to see my mask. And that's looking pretty good. And then hold Alt. I'm going to erase off of the hill here. Great, press O again, and then I can just lower my exposure like that, maybe add some contrast, take the blacks down. And one thing you can do if you're having issues with pulling the sky back too much and it's making those weird splotchy purpley colors, all you have to do is just take your noise and turn that up, and my clarity, I can turn that down because there's really not a whole lot going on in here. I can take my sharpness down too, and that'll help blend things together. And you can see that in this image, there's still some weird kind of speckles going on here. So I can actually just make that a little bit less of a drastic change. Zoom back out. Here's before, and here's after. So I hope you can see how easy and fast this is. It lets you So I hope you can see how easy and fast it is to replace the details in the sky by pulling the exposure back down, just making yourself a nice auto. So obviously this is a super easy, quick way to mask out your sky and get your details back without moving into Photoshop and just recovering the highlights from our sky ever so easily and fast. Again, if you're having issues with weird splotches going on, you can just lower your sharpness, turn your denoising on a little bit, ditch the saturation, or just take your effect back so it's a little more subtle. There's going to be a limit to how much detail you can actually rescue in your image. It all depends on the raw file. So before you try and push things too far, you can always check and just say, okay, if I take this down, is there still color in the clouds? Yes, there is. Okay, I'm going to go ahead and edit this as I would. And if not, then you're going to have to look at a technique like replacing the sky inside of Photoshop. So we'll just do a couple more here. Now in this case, this image isn't working very well. And why is that? Well, it's because if we actually take a look at our image, our colors are not super distinct. Yes, the sky is much brighter than the rest of the image. However, it's not a whole lot different in color and exposure on some of these reflections on the buildings, etc. So one thing that we can try is turning our range mask on. So I'm going to click in here, as I was before, just on the different areas of this sunset. And once I've done that, I'm going to take my range mask, turn it on to luminance. So what that's going to do is it's going to filter out any darker areas based on the setting that I give it. So I'm going to slide my shadows up. And you can see that slowly but surely, Lightroom is omitting the darker areas of the image from this mask. Just like that. So this is without the range mask. And this is with it on. So then I can proceed as normal. Press O again to see what I'm doing. Take my exposure down a little bit, and we'll just be darkening the road here and the sunset. Now, if you want to get some really great popping colors, take your clarity up, your contrast up a little bit. Just exaggerate the highlights and shadows ever so slightly, a little bit of saturation, a little bit of sharpness. And a little bit of noise is going to help as you're pulling the details back. Great, and let's keep going. So this next image is a fantastic example of where this technique can save you a ton of time. We've got a very complicated mountain right here, which would be so hard for me to manually go in there and draw my mask in by myself. However, if I zoom back out, using our technique, take this adjustment brush, size 100, feather all the way down, flow all the way up, auto mask, and then I click here in the sky. Bam, one click, two clicks, three clicks. You can kind of paint on there, and eventually Lightroom will clue in. Now that is the only part about using an auto mask function. Sometimes it's not going to do exactly what you want it to do, but that's fine. We can always try our range mask trick again. Take our luminance slider, slide that up, and you can see how now it's only affecting the very white portions of the image, the parts that are very bright indeed. Great. So now I'm going to pull that back. And just like that, we've got a whole lot of detail in the sky that otherwise would have been lost. I can make the sky more blue by lowering that white balance a little bit, turn my saturation up, and even a little bit of dehaze maybe. Perfect. Here's before, and here's after. Big difference, eh? Same thing goes for this image. Obviously, our foreground here is super, super dark because whoever took this photo was exposing for the sky. Generally, that's the best possible rule because you do not want to lose the highlights in the sky. If that were gone when I pulled it down, if it just stayed white, there's nothing I can do. But because I can see that all of the sky detail is still there, it's okay. All I have to do is grab my little brush, press O here, click, 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 and now I'm going to switch to my second brush just to go over these areas once more. Press O again, pull my exposure back. And just like that, we have our beautiful sky once more. Isn't that incredible? Now, obviously, you're going to want to edit the rest of the image too so that things don't look quite so weird and unnatural, but in about 30 seconds, I was able to do something that manually would have been next to impossible or taken me a long time. Here is before, and here is after. All right, two more and we're done. This photo was taken at Zion National Park. We're just going to delete everything here. All we have to do to get this guy back is first we're going to check if there is detail. Yes and no. This is a good example of what happens when you overexpose your photo and there's just nothing you can do, because down here where the sun is setting, you can clearly see there's some white areas that no matter how far down I take my slider, they're going to stay white. That's because they were blown out in the actual camera. There's nothing we can do to get them back. But the rest of this image, we still have a shot at getting some detail back. So what I'm going to do is the same as the other images. Zoom out. Go to my large brush. Press O to see what it's doing. Perfect, and you can see there's a lot of detail around this tree that otherwise, if I were trying to paint this manually, it would be a hopeless process. But because we're using the auto brush in Lightroom, we're getting pretty good results very, very fast. So now go to my secondary brush, and I'm very lightly just going to brush on top of these trees. Turn my flow down, and that's going to minimize the effects of those weird kind of white splotches. And that can be a good technique too. See here on the mountain where we've got this kind of weird line going on. By painting on top of it, just very lightly, we can make it a little bit less extreme. Okay, so let's zoom out. Press O again. Take our exposure down. Not that far. Lightroom is not playing very nice with me right now. It's kind of stalling, so it's hard for me to tell what it actually looks like. Great. So again, here's before, completely white, and after. In this case, we're not going to get as much detail back simply because it was gone. We never captured it in camera, so it's too late. Now, obviously, the work that I did to make this little transition a little more subtle actually wound up making everything look weird, so I'd have to go through and probably redo that again. The easiest way to do that is with our auto brush. Just click on that area. Perfect. Okay, one more and we're done. This is an example, again, of just maximizing dynamic range without making it look weird. This portion of the ferry is clearly a lot darker than the sky, and that's fine, but if I want to brighten it up and get more detail out of the sky, all I have to do, zoom out, click on that sky, and you can see that it's not working exceptionally well in this particular image. Why is that? Well, sometimes the colors are just too close together. We've got blue sky, blue water, and all of that is reflecting blue light onto this now blue building. And so to do this, we're going to have to be a little bit more manual, a little bit less automatic. We're going to select all the water in the sky here. Then after that, we're going to go over onto our erase. Or actually, we'll go down to our range mask. Use that. Take our range all the way up. And now we've just selected this guy. Awesome. So we'll take that exposure down. Contrast way up. Add some blue. Get that really blue sky and the blue mountains in the back. And take our blacks down. Perfect. So we've gone from here to here. Now we can take the rest of the image a little bit more bright without losing any of the detail in the sky. So that is how you edit the sky in Lightroom, getting your details back without having to replace the sky in Photoshop. I hope this was helpful for you. If it was, please leave me a comment. Let me know. I want to hear it. Make sure to hit that like button and subscribe for more great content. I will see you in the next one.